All right, Shannon Vlogs, 31 Days of Horror, continuing with Day 9 and Candyman, 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 uh-oh. All right, everyone, hey, it's Shannon, and I'm very excited to get to today's 31 Days of Horror selection of Candyman. This is actually recommended to me by Lunaria Claire, or Claire. I don't know what her new channel is called, but Claire, Claire Bear, we know Claire. Hey, Claire. So I will leave her channel link below if you don't know her, and you can check out her videos. And I think she recommended this to me the other time, the last time I did the 31 Days of Horror in 2012. And I think I bought it then, but I was hold but it didn't come in time or something. And then I was holding it. I was holding it, waiting to do it and share it in another 31 Days of Horror. So I finally got a chance to watch it. It was one of those sort of blind spots in horror for me. I feel like everyone had seen it but me. And so it was kind of nice to get to it. I was a bit leery from the fact that it's from the 90s, and I don't always love 90s horror, but I did end up enjoying this one. Yes. It is also based on a Clive Barker story, and I don't know if I've seen other stuff that has been adaptations of his work, but I feel like I must have, but I don't think I haven't read anything, and I don't know what, if anything else, I've seen that's an adaptation of his work, but there must be something. There's a lot of his stuff gets adapted. So anyway, let's go and take a look at where this story begins. And so this is from 1992, and it follows two friends. Ah, that makes sense. I wouldn't have been able to see this in the theater. So there's a piece that makes sense of why I haven't seen it. Depends on what it was rated. Anyway, we'll leave that for now. Anyway, so it follows two friends who are studying in, or who are working on their thesis, and they are researching urban legends. Like, honestly, if someone had just told me that that's what it was about, I would have totally just gone for it because that's totally awesome. And then anyway, so they follow the story of, or at least one of them gets really interested in the urban legend of Candyman, which is the lore goes that if you say his name 5 times into a mirror, he appears and with a hook and kills you. So why would anyone say this? Like, this is the kind of thing, especially si feels similar to the Bloody Mary urban legend. But it isn't, but it's a different story. Anyway, so, but again, why would anyone do it? I guess it's kind of that, like, dare you to do this kind of thing. So that's how it goes. The film stars Virginia Madsen and Tony Todd. I absolutely love Virginia Madsen, and she was amazing in this. One of the nice things about horror, or one of the traits of horror that can be, but isn't always the case, is that we might first see someone in a horror movie, usually, female actors. I don't usually say actresses, that's why I said female actors. But often female characters that are portrayed by actors. Now I'm just running around with different wordplay. Women who are in horror movies often go on to other movies. They don't always, but sometimes they get their first acting gigs in horror movies. I don't think this is her first thing, but now she's very, well known, Oscar nominated, just a great actor. So it's wild to go back and see her, with her 80s, like, curly poofy hair, and or 90s, early 90s sort of perm and some of the stylings in the film. But anyway, and then of course Tony Todd, who's in like a million things. Although he wasn't in this as much as I expected, especially for being on the cover. Anyway, we'll get to more of that later. So first, for next question is, was it horror? Like, yeah, this is gonna be anything other than horror. You're dealing with urban legends, you're dealing with a lot of terrorization, you're dealing with like everything, the supernatural elements, a lot of brutality, a lot of gore, a lot of blood, lots of terrifying things. This is horror on all levels. Yeah, and lots of awesome practical effects in this one. From, oh, I can't say that. I'm looking at my notes and like, that's a spoiler, so I won't say that. Lots of horror effects. But also at the heart of it, there's a really good story. The drama in this is good, and the acting is good. So that really gives it a lot of, like, just ticks off a lot of awesome boxes. So I was really happy about that. Next off, I was it scary? I would actually say yes, but I wasn't necessarily scared per se. I think I should change that to that question to was it scary versus was I scared? Because I don't, there's barely any of films that scare me anymore, but I definitely think this one had definitely terrifying moments in it, not just in terms of like gore and blood and guts and that kind of stuff and attacks and threatening situations and stuff, but also the idea of it, not only the idea of Candyman, but the journey that Virginia Madison's character goes on is pretty like freaky. So there is a lot, like, just there's a lot compelling to it. So I think maybe, you know, it's not necessarily like I'm scared in this moment, but wow, isn't that a terrifying thing to happen? So I think it gets that on a bunch of different levels, because the story itself is wild, and then there's tons of huge, tons of horror elements, like just so many different things. And did I enjoy it? If you cannot tell already, hell yes, I really enjoyed this one. I ended up giving it an 8.5 out of 10, and I couldn't quite go to 9 because I don't know why. Maybe it was the 90s-ness of it. Like, for me, 90s films are really, I just don't tend to like them. And this one, I felt nostalgic, you know, in a weird way. Weird way. But I think for me, the things that make it so great are the acting. Virginia Madsen is amazing. Tony Todd is so great. Like, he's so great. I love him as an actor. You know, if you aren't familiar with him, he's in the Final Destination films. He's in Hatchet. And he was also in The Rock. You know, if you want to see him in a dramatic role, it's a smaller role, but you know, he often in horror, you know, he's the big bad. He's a huge guy. You know, he's like 6'5" or something like that. So he often plays the villain. I don't know why. I'd love to see him in a non-villainous role. That would be really cool. But he's great as the villain as well. And yeah, so there was such great energy in this movie. The story was really interesting. It definitely went some places I wasn't expecting, but overall, it was just really nice. And I was really happy to break the my 90s horror, like, not enjoying-ness factor. So for me, I probably rated it, I don't know, I think, no, an 8.5 is that. It was, I enjoyed it, but I enjoyed it more than just enjoying it. So that feels fair to me. I did do a drawing for this one. I was actually quite happy with how this one turned out. It sort of starts at the bottom. I did end up freezing the screen to get that picture. And then the rest is more of just interpretive. Still feel like I could use a little, some darker up here. But overall, I'm pretty happy with